What up, dudes? This video that you're about to watch was filmed 2 months ago when I first got back to the UK. The day I landed, I drove to a festival called Triplicity. It was a small-scale psytrance festival in the mid-Wales. I wanted to go because a bunch of my friends were there, and I just felt like go to a festival. When I was there, I decided to take some LSD that I had. Prior to this, I hadn't taken LSD or any drug for about 7 weeks, so I was completely sober for 7 weeks while I was traveling, and I hadn't had a proper acid trip since September. Yeah, quite a long time. So I didn't really know what to expect going into this. Of course, with this channel now, I film all my trips because I want to document them and show you guys how drugs work, because nobody really explains how they work by showing you. Like, you can talk about stuff forever, you can read about it as much as you want, but to really understand something, you have to see it. Or at least that's how I work. So this is mainly for harm reduction and for education. Don't watch this video thinking I'm trying to promote drugs. That's not what I'm trying to do. People are gonna do drugs no matter what. So it's good for people to do them safely and know how to do them safely. I didn't really explain that in this video. I did in the first episode. My general theme is take psychedelics out in nature. If you're gonna take them in nature. And it's good to have someone around to be a trip setter. I had a bunch of friends with me, so I was totally fine. The tabs are meant to be 220 mics, but I've had them for a while and they probably evaporated a little bit, and the dosage didn't feel like that. This was 2 days of tripping. So LSD takes about 2 weeks to get your tolerance to come back up. So if you take it, it's gonna take about 2 weeks for you to get the same trip. But I try to do 2 days in a row just to see what would happen. I documented it. The first episode of this is actually on my second channel. If you haven't seen that, I'd recommend going and watch it. It's very different to this one. You might enjoy it. I was completely on my own out in America filming it, so that was on my second channel. It was meant to come on this channel, but I decided not to put it on here for some reason, and I put it on there. Because it was the first episode, I wanted to see what the reaction was gonna be like, and the reaction was really good. That video got like 100,000 views, so a lot of people are interested. So this is episode 2. Episode 3 is already filmed. That'll come out whenever it comes out. If you're new here, please subscribe. I make psychedelic related content on here, and on my second channel I do travel style stuff. Something for everyone. Also, if you're not into drugs at all, just try and keep an open mind watching this. You just gotta understand that we've been programmed from birth to believe that these drugs are really bad. It's only the people that actually take them and break the rules, they're the ones that find out the truth. If you think drugs are bad, just watch this video. Tell me which parts seem bad to you. Alright, back to pass, Jason.
I knew that was gonna happen. I got in my blankets and fell asleep.
Of course that was gonna happen.
That could have been a combination of jet lag, the edible, and just because it was late.
I slept great.
At some point during the night, I opened my door, and because it was too hot. Oh man, it's nice out here. I've been just lying in my car eating snacks. I think I've got the munchies still. People have been climbing that mountain over there all morning. And I want to do it, but I'm gonna wait till Duncan and everybody are awake, because they all wanted to do it as well.
Ah, look how cool this camp is. Wow.
Yes, triplicity. There is a bug on my finger.
What do you want, little bug?
My little car.
Well, the bug's still on me. What do you want, bug?
I'm probably gonna end up climbing all these mountains.
I'm gonna do some acid layer, but for now, I'm gonna go set up my hammock.
Yeah, there's some trees like up there. I'm gonna set my hammock up over there.
Gonna wash myself down here.
Ah, yeah.
I just bumped into my friend Leia. I saw her last night, but I didn't get to say hi to her. I haven't seen her in like a year, maybe 2 years.
Oh, this forest is magical. The hammock is up. The knots are terrible. I need to redo them.
I don't go camping enough, so like I always forget how to tie up my hammock. It's really frustrating because I just spent so long and it's not even gonna stay up. Now I'm gonna go find Dunk, see if everybody else is awake. It's like, it's already gone midday now, but because the sun sets so late here, people tend to go to bed later. Yeah, the sun sets at like 9:30, something like crazy like that. Like I'm not used to this because this is like different to where I was. The sun was setting in Japan at like 6 o'clock.
We've started the hike.
I don't know if it's slipping or not. I think it's attached.
Yeah. We found a cable. We're gonna climb up the mountain using this.
Go from there, get the festival in.
Ha ha ha. Oh. Yeah. There's a tiny bit of blue sky up there. Tiny bit. There's a storm coming towards us. Yeah.
Like in the bark of trees.
Oh yeah. Whoa. Yes.
I've seen photos of this area.
Really?
Yeah. Loads of social services, so loads of disabled people have been dying. Career's an interesting one. Career was split between America and the Russian.
Yeah.
North Korea is the enemy of America, and therefore those two countries as well.
Man, just walking on this stuff is so trippy. It's squishy. Ugh. Come this way around, it'll be easier. Oh man. Yep. Whoa. It's so much crazier up here. What is that? What is that sound? We went through that one, and then there's a path back behind this one. We followed the path all the way around. It kind of zigzags, and then you come back through here. I walked through all of this earlier and it looks so different now.
Yeah, I was just going for the show.
You blended so well. loads of midges out, so we're trying to get away from them. Focus, 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 yeah. Slightly more prepared now. I think it's time to go in. I have no concept of time anymore, so looking at the night sky and seeing light is tripping me out a little bit. I've forgotten how to speak like me. I don't know why. It's so weird hearing all these different British accents after just coming back from traveling. I don't know which accent to hold on to, so I sound weird to myself. What happened to my car? It got pooped on. Wait, what? It wasn't that day before. Why am I in here? Oh, right. Sorry, the sky was tripping me out. Everything's pretty trippy. I'm trying to film the thoughts that I had while I don't know what to do with the torch. Okay. I'm trying to... This is what the other acid video is like. I can't get the lighting right. So one of the thoughts I had while I was down there was, it's just gonna sound stupid if I say it out loud. I feel like everything that I was witnessing down there, everything that I felt a part of, that's what the hippie time was like. That's what they felt like, just tripping out with a bunch of colorful, funny looking hippie people. It's exactly the same. Years aren't a thing. Everything that was happening then is happening now. You just gotta look for it, and I think I finally found it. I feel like it doesn't matter that I wasn't born in the 70s. It's all happening. It's all happening right now. Tucked away. If you're not a part of the psytrance family, it is pretty fun. Why am I back in my car? Oh, I can't decide what to wear. I feel like I want to take this hoodie off because it's making me sweat too much. But it's really frosty outside, so I don't know if I should wear my poncho. I'm seeing loads of people over there with cool beards, like dreaded beards and stuff, and I can't wait until mine's that big. I think I've decided. I'm just gonna commit to it. Just grow it. It looks stupid now, but that's what my dreads look like. They look stupid when I started. So the beard's gonna look stupid for a bit. And then I can start dyeing it, and then dreading it. And then I'll look like a real hippie. done the best I can at capturing the first night here, but now I've got to, like, if I'm going to go for this, I'm going to really go for this. So it's been 2 years since acid fell into my life. I'm going to go on a little acid binge because I haven't touched any drugs in like seven weeks, and with all my friends. But yeah, I just want to see what happens to me. So this is, I'm going to leave my camera here. I might do some more acid. I'm probably going to do some more. Hello, hello, hello. I made it until the next morning. I ate another quarter of a tab. So that's about 50 mics. So I'm on 270 mics, which have been nice. I haven't, nothing too crazy. I haven't lost my mind. Still here. It's been really fun. Just been on the main stage with all my friends. Just hammering it by the speakers. Our little crew are like, we're like the last few out there. There's not very many people left dancing at this time. There's bugs all over my hand. Whoa. There's bugs all over me. Can I capture this? Being bitten by a lot of bugs. Yeah, I made it. So now I can take my camera. I've been charging this camera in the car while I've been wandering. I'm being bit by a lot of bugs. The idea to this video is, I want to throw this on the main channel. I just want to show what it's like properly to be on acid, because the last video that I shot like this, I was on a really small dose and I was on my own and I was in the woods. This is completely different. This is a setting that's really good and safe. Wow, there's so many bugs. Can you even see them on the camera? They're so small. Yeah, you can see them. Little punks. This is a really good environment to be tripping. Because it's very safe. All my friends are around. So I'm not alone. And I think because of that, I can let loose a bit more because I know I'm safe. Yeah, it's cool. It's so good to be around all these guys again. I've been so lonely on this travels. It feels so good to be around my friends, and I don't think they understand that, and I'm not really good at telling them either, but they mean a lot to me, and I can't really thank them enough for just being my friend, because I don't have very many real friends. Like, I have loads of friends, but not friends that will come out to a field with me and stomp until the morning. Like, these friends are good friends. These are the guys that I travelled Europe with in 2015, and it's really cool to see them all here. The crazy thing is, I don't remember how I found triplicity online, but I found it. It just fell into my life, and now I'm here. I'm rambling. I'm wearing more clothes. I've been eating nuts. I'm running out of food. That's kind of scary, because I need food. The sun has risen. The sun is up. Time for me to go to bed. I'm really cold right now, and I couldn't find any of my friends at the main stage, so I figured they'd all gone to bed. But then I checked like the big tent, and there was only a few people asleep. I've grabbed my stuff. I'm gonna go sleep in my hammock. There it is. The sheep are so confused. This is a really interesting time to catch all the sheep, because they're being like completely normal. I caught them off guard, I think. I might have woken them up as well. So many midges. I need to get in a sleeping bag. I fell asleep for a bit on accident. I was gonna lie here and just watch the sunrise, but then there were like so many midges, that so many flying bitey bugs, that I decided to just, I covered my head and didn't, I can't English very good. I covered my head. I was trying to hide from all the bugs. I guess I was just in there for too long because I fell asleep. Woke up and it's raining a little bit. My ears, my head, everything kind of hurts.
I've got a kettle just like next to my bed. First thing I do, I wake up, my alarm, I just put the kettle on, and the snooze goes on. 10 minutes I go back to sleep.
Yeah.
And then it goes up again.
And then the kettle's done.
And the kettle's already done then. So then I pour it in. I've already got the coffee ready, so I set it up the night before. And I just pour the water in, and then I go back to sleep for 10 minutes, and it goes up again. Then by then, it's cooled down enough to drink.
Wow.
So after 20 minutes, I drink the coffee. And then I go to sleep again.
So this is the second day I'm doing. Today I've already had, probably gonna do more acid today than I did yesterday. Only a little bit more, just to see what happens. This is like the last full day of the festival, so yeah. This video is gonna be a little mixture of everything, see what it's like to be tripping for 2 days straight. Hallucinations have already started. They started up there. Should be. Bugs. Can't handle it. Because I was tripping out and then it started raining and now I can't leave. Okay, I feel like I've sobered up now. How did my nose get burnt? The festival's basically over. I just need to figure out which tent has got my pink shirt in and then I can go home. I didn't see any of my friends yesterday. Like, I don't know where they all went. But oh well. I'm happy I saw them all yesterday and I just want to go home now. I'm tired, hungry. Weird time. I'll do a little trip report in a minute. This is my first wrap in 2 months. It's so good, but I accidentally put too much hot sauce on it, and it really hurts. In Tesco though, this guy with gray dreads, they looked so cool. He was like an old dude. And we smiled at each other. So last night, I ended up taking 3 tabs.
and I got stuck in my head. I couldn't get out, really. So I couldn't socialize. I was crying quite a lot. I wasn't hallucinating too much. I wasn't really, like, nothing really crazy was happening. It was just, I couldn't get out of my head. I could dance a little bit. Like, I was throwing my energy into, like, movement a little bit, but not as much as I wanted to. My feet really hurt. Like, I've damaged them quite a lot. I think the second night I screwed them up. My feet just really hurt. I haven't acclimatized to the temperature, and it was so freezing last night. And I ended up just lying on the ground by the fire, trying to, like, survive. And then it started raining on me, so I went into this, like, igloo tent thing. I couldn't sleep because I was tripping, so I was just people watching. The close-eye visuals were really nice. Nothing too colourful, but the patterns were all there. A few times it got a bit scary, but I didn't go too deep. Like, if you do acid 2 days in a row, the second day is not going to be anywhere near as strong as you want it to be. My friend Dunk was saying that it takes like 24 hours. You have like a 24-hour immediate tolerance, so if you wait another day, then do it, then it'll be weird again. I look pretty exhausted right now. Yeah, it was fun. I'm glad I did it. I feel better now after not having tripped in so long. It's September was the last time I tripped properly, so it was nice to have a trip. Nothing crazy. I was hoping it would get a bit crazy, but nothing really wild happened. My tattoos are healing pretty good. I was trying to look after them as much as I could while I was dancing around. Yeah, I hope this video is a little bit interesting. It's just one of my trips. Every trip's different. That's the crazy thing. It's never what you want. It's never what you expect. It shows you what you need to see. I did get to reflect and think about some deep stuff that I've been repressing. So that was good. It brought it up, made me deal with it. And now I can change my life a little bit more. That's the best thing it does, is like while you're dancing around, psytrance puts you into a trance. So when you're in that trance, you can then wiggle your body around and think about your whole life. It pulls everything up, puts it on the table, and then it makes you sort through it. So I'm just holding this wrap. Alright, I'm gonna drive home. Wales, screw you for being so cold. Midges, cold, wet. Can't deal. I'm not ready for this. I'm not ready to come back to this crap. Alright, I hope you enjoyed that video. I think it's a good one. If you did, please tell me in the comments. I'd love to have feedback on this kind of stuff, because this is like a new genre of YouTube. Not many people are doing what I'm doing. So I need some feedback. Just give me positive, negative, I don't mind. If you didn't like the video, give it a dislike. If you liked the video, give it a like. If you want to see episode 1, it is right here on the screen right now. Just click that. It'll take you through to episode 1. Episode 3 will be out soon. Every trip I have is going to be documented. I've got a follow-up on the Changa video. That'll be coming soon. It's very hard to deprogram people. People don't understand the truth until they go looking for it. Like, even if it's right in front of their face, they won't believe it until they do their own research. So for any of you that are watching this now, you're doing your own research. You're trying to find out about these psychedelics. You're trying to find out about these compounds. That's a good step. I'm sure there's a lot of people out there more experienced than myself. So I'd love to hear from you. I'm always trying to learn. For me, making these videos is my way of learning. Like, I get to watch myself back tripping. Who gets to do that? It's an interesting experience. I get to learn a lot. If you're from the LSD subreddit, hi. I've been a long-time lurker over there. I posted this there because I wanna interact with some of you guys. All right, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.